We take you now to a press conference with Senator Harry Reid and Speaker of the House, Nancy Pelosi.
We are here tonight to update you on the progress of the economic stimulus package.
A package I believe should be passed quickly.
And one I hope to achieve with bipartisan support.
Ugh.
Nancy.
Last week, the House passed a package of $819 billion. And Tuesday, the Senate will vote to approve a number closer to $780 billion. But we want to stress, don't focus too much on these numbers.
It will just bum you out. No one knows how much money this is going to take.
If we thought you'd be cool with a trillion, we'd take a trillion.
We'd take it in a heartbeat. Now, in the Senate, we made some concessions and now expect some support from both parties.
If by both parties, you mean three Republicans.
Nancy, please.
And in the House, we made no concessions because, thanks to our majority, we don't have to. In fact, our package was so true to our core Democratic principles, even some Democrats voted against it. That's how you play a majority.
Nancy, we want to bring bipartisanship back to Washington.
We do. And can I say that I am so happy that bipartisanship is so important to Republicans again. For 8 years, they didn't seem to care much about reaching across the aisle, but now it's boo-hoo, what about us? Give me a break. After they treated the Democrats like sewer rats for 8 years, we were worried that bipartisanship didn't matter to them. Harry, I just had a thought. Do you think they changed their tune because we're their majority now? Harry, do you?
Nancy.
Huh? Fine.
That's enough.
Fine.
Now, Nancy and I both understand that passing a bill like this is going to be a messy process.
I only wish we had a Democratic president in control of both houses. Oh, wait, we do. So I guess we won't have to pander to Republicans.
Nancy, please.
On that note, I will admit some disappointment in Harry and his colleagues for cutting $50 billion in education funding.
Nancy.
Because I thought we cared about schools.
Well, maybe if you hadn't put in over $200 million for condoms, we wouldn't have been in such a tough position.
Can I say something about condoms?
You probably shouldn't.
Now, I know it's a blast to poke fun of San Fran Nancy for her ideas about sex ed, but maybe if we spent money on condoms and education, the next generation won't have so many stupid people running around ruining our economy. But no, yeah, by all means, I'm the villain. The hero is the lady with six kids who had octuplets. Let's get her on Oprah, huh? Let's get her on Oprah.
To conclude, we would like to applaud this and further bipartisan efforts. In this trying time, we need to put aside our differences.
Although, if push comes to shove, let's try and remember something. We won. We run things now.
Nancy, control yourself.
You can't control a majority. And live from New York, it's Saturday night!